Hello children, already we have seen something about the seeds, is it? Now we are going to read how the seeds are for their texture and how it is wandering here and there and what is the best thing of a seed. We will see now. Take your EVS book and then open to the book to the page number 46. See, we have done this. Is it last class we have done how we have to make the sprout? Let's see this. Plants which hunt. It means some of the plants can hunt ourselves. For example, this is an hunting animal, hunting plant. For this name is Nebanthus. What is that? Nebanthus. It is not in here. In India, we can see this. Meghalaya and Indonesia Island. Okay, we can see this one lot in Australia. What is the information they have given in this about this plant here? Let's see this. Plants which hunt. There are some plants which trap and eat frog, insects and even mice. The pitcher plant. What is the name? We can say this name Nebanthus. We can another name for that. Call this pitcher plant. It's one such plant. It is found in Australia, Indonesia and Meghalaya in India. Okay. It has a pitcher like shape and the mouth is covered by a leaf. The plant has a special smell that attracts insects into it. When the insect lands on the mouth of the plant, it gets trapped and cannot get out. What a clever way to hunt. See, this is the mouth of the plant. Okay, this is a leaf. It's look like a leaf. See this. It can, when the insects or anything on a stand or sitting into the plant here, it swallow it. We can't move from this plant. So then it can eat well. So like this plants also we have in our world. Okay, see this. So many seeds. How many types of seeds can you collect? Where will you find them? Each of should try to collect as many different types of seeds as you can. After that, all the seed collection together. Observe these seeds carefully. The shapes, sizes, colors and textures. Texture means their characteristic, like a characteristic. See, lot of seeds are here. Some seeds are rough, some seeds are smooth, is it? We have to collect some seeds from our home. Okay, what are the spices thing we are having into our home? Just take that and make it as a table like this. Name of the seed and then color, their shape and texture. You just draw the shape. Okay, take 5 seeds, minimum 5 things you just take and write the name of the seed. For example, Rajma. Rajma means it's like a soya bean. Okay, its color is reddish brown. I mean maroon, little bit maroon color. Okay, that seed size texture is so smooth. Then channa seed is it's to be like a heart shape. The what is the color? We have a black and white and the texture smooth, sometimes rough. Black channa rough, white channa smooth. Okay, like that you have to write. Did you keep aniseed and cumin in your list? Sanf and jeera, jeeragam and soombu. Which was the smallest seed? Which was the biggest seed in your collection? The biggest seed is sanf, aniseed, soombu. The smallest seed is cumin, it means jeera. Okay, like that you have to make a list of spices used in our home. Seeds of vegetables, seeds of fruits, light seed, and which seeds are flat, which seeds are rough. Like that you have to write. Make a table. And wandering seeds. How does the seed are wandering from here and there? Plants cannot move around. Is it? Once they grow, they remain in the same place. But their seeds are great travelers. They can reach far and wide. Look at the picture 1 on the next page. See the flying seeds. How was the seeds of making wandering here and there? By blowing air, by water, throwing an animal, throw the seed, throwing the way of from a human and animals and birds. Like that only the word seeds are wandering. Have you ever seen any seed that can fly? Yeah, that cotton seed. What is it called in your area? This is called in our area cotton. What is this plant? Cotton. By blowing only, flying. Look at your seed collection. Guess how many of that seed could have traveled by flying. Picture 2. The seed cannot fly, but it can travel by sticking on the fur of animals or on our cloth. Yeah, that is it's to be some seed that driest area only we can see this one. Okay, for that if it is touched in our fur, animal's fur or anything, it's can't move. Velcro means ottikrathu. Okay, Velcro came to the green mistral. See this, how is the Velcro is working? This happened in 1948. One day, George Mistral came back from a walk with his dog. He was amazed to find seeds sticking all over his clothes and on his dog's fur. He wondered what made them stick. So he observed these seeds under a microscope. Microscope, did you see anywhere? If you be here, I will show one time. Okay. He saw that the seeds had many tiny holes which got stuck to cloths or fur. This gave Mistral the idea of making Velcro. Like that only, the Velcro material made in our area. He made a material with a similar tiny hooks that would stick. Velcro is used to stick together many things, cloths, shoes, bags, belts and many more. What a way to take inspiration from nature. If you see any of the things from the nature, what is the thing we will get from that? Just you have to think like this. This is a thing happened from George Mistral. Okay, see this. The each and every animals and birds, that plant also throwing the seeds. See the bird, the parrot taking some seed, then that squirrel, then here the banana tree. It's a banana tree something, but it's making some ripe food anything down. So like that only the seeds are flying around. Okay, who came from where? What is the thing came from where? We have a song, like a song. We will see this now. Have you included human beings also in your list? Yes, we also carry seeds from one place to another. Knowingly or unknowingly, we bring the seeds of plants that we find beautiful or useful to grow them in our garden. Later, the seeds of these plants spread to other places. Many years later, people may not even remember that these plants did not grow here earlier. They were brought from somewhere else. Do you know from where chilies came to our country? These were brought to India by traders coming from South America. Today, we cannot think of food without chilies. Yeah, do you like without spices thing? See this song. From South America long ago came a tomato, a potato and a green chili. What are things we are getting from South America? Tomato, potato and green chili. Do you know this? A cabbage from Europe and also a pea. Pea means patani. From Africa came a coffee bean and a green bindi. Bindi means vendaka, lady's finger. They crossed the land, they crossed the sea. Did you know this? Yeah, absolutely. They have crossed the land and the sea. See, a mango sang, "Come on, coming, coming." An orange smiled inside its skin. Welcome to India. We have this in India. A banana said, "The methi and spinach, brinjal and radish," nodded its head.
Then other vegetables are nodded. Nodded means thalaiyaatrathu. Did you know this?
Yeah. Not at all here. Lot of plants are we are getting from lots of areas. So we have learnt lot of seeds sprouted. The seeds need sprouting. Then we have what are the seeds? What are the seeds are we are using? Everything we can make some plant, is it? So if you can make some spices, what you have used in our home, just make it as a plant. Okay, students. Thank you. We have completed 5th lesson. Let's see the 6th lesson in our next class. Okay, students. Thank you.